The F-35, one of the most advanced aircraft ever built, and an ambitious attempt to make a fifth-generation fighter the mainstay of the American fighter fleet. Such an accomplishment would be tantamount to another of America's famous offsets, or technologies that set the US apart from the rest of the world and make it a dominant military power. A fully fifth-generation fighter fleet would put every air power in the world at serious risk and guarantee the continued domination of any airspace over any nation by the United States' Air Force. Yet the F-35 has proven to be as troublesome as it is ambitious, and while some initial problems are always expected of new aircraft, some of the F-35's crippling deficiencies may end up turning the US from the most dominant air power on Earth to the most vulnerable. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Infographics Show. Today we're taking a look at why the F-35 isn't ready for war. Originally billed in 2001 as a cheap multi-role fighter that could fulfill a variety of combat roles, the F-35 was, as many now fear, too good to be true. The aircraft would be stealthy, not as stealth-capable as the B-2 bomber or even the F-22 Raptor, but far stealthier than any fourth-generation platform. In a world with ever-improving anti-air defenses, vastly improving targeting computers, and more accurate radars, stealth was seen by the US Pentagon as the only way for a future fighter to remain survivable over hostile airspace. The F-35 would also be designed to fulfill various mission roles, including ground attack capabilities to support troops in need of air support, air-to-air superiority, amphibious assault, and electronic warfare. And it would do all these things for the incredibly cheap price tag of $38 million per plane. With the Air Force's F-15 Strike Eagle averaging a cost of $31.8 million, this price tag was a steal for Congress. Yet the F-35 is averaging $158.4 million per plane, and while that figure will inevitably drop as production moves to full rate, it is still way over cost and will never come close to the original $38 million price tag. Not only is the plane way overpriced, but despite some units achieving initial operational readiness status, the plane continues to severely underperform in several critical areas, such as availability and reliability, cyber vulnerability, and life expectancy. Perhaps even more troubling, the Director of Operational Test and Evaluation's 2018 report on the aircraft showed an incredible lack of transparency and absolutely no updates on crippling vulnerabilities identified in earlier annual reports. As a result, the American taxpayer is in the dark about the status of the most expensive weapons program in history. But about the only thing that is clear is that its much-vaunted fifth-generation fighter is in no way ready for war. The most important measure of an aircraft's readiness for combat is its fully mission-capable rate, or the percentage of aircraft that have fully functional non-degraded vehicle systems such as flight controls and engine, electronic mission systems such as radar, electronic warfare systems and its computers, and weapons employment capabilities. In 2017, the F-35 had a 26% fully mission-capable rate across the entire fleet. Not entirely unexpected, as the aircraft was still very much in late stages of development. However, the 2018 Director of Operational Test and Evaluations report failed to mention what readiness was across the entire fleet, leaving many to suspect that readiness has decreased rather than increased. So what exactly is wrong with the F-35? Or at least, what do we know that's wrong with it? The F-35 is armed with a 25mm gun for use in both close air support for ground troops and in dogfighting situations should the plane find itself in one. Yet the F-35's gun has famously not been able to shoot straight for years. In a ground attack role, strafing with a gun is preferred over missiles or bombs because guns are more accurate and less dangerous to friendly forces when used on enemy troops in close combat, or when civilians are in the area. Yet while the Navy and Marine Corps' F-35s have had their guns fixed, the Air Force's F-35A still cannot shoot straight, and instead shoots long and to the right of targets when pilots aim using cues projected inside their helmets. Despite repeated attempts to patch this software bug over the last 2 years, the Air Force's F-35As still seem to be no closer to a fix and will be banned from using their cannon in an in-ground attack role for the foreseeable future. Should an Air Force F-35A find itself in a dogfight scenario, the glitch may just prove fatal for the pilot. It's not just the gun's accuracy that's in question, though. So is the amount of ammunition, typically 182 rounds, as well as the type of ammunition it fires. Though the F-35 is slated to replace the venerable and much-feared A-10 Warthog as the Air Force's ground attack aircraft, The F-35A carries about one-tenth the ammunition of a Warthog, which carries 1,350 rounds. Testing of the various ammunition types fired by the F-35 also throws into question its efficacy. For while the Warthog is famously able to penetrate the top armor of modern tanks with its 30mm cannon, the F-35's 25mm cannon has only been tested in limited quantities against lightly armored and plywood targets. Most worrisome is the fact that there seems to be no further gun effectiveness testing planned for the future. The F-35 is also showing key failures in durability testing. Each new aircraft is supposed to have a service life of 8,000 flight hours, the standard for any military aircraft. To ensure that a new airframe is designed to last, each model is put through rigorous testing that simulates 3 lifetimes worth, or 24,000 hours of structural load testing. This intense testing is meant to simulate the massive stresses placed on the airframe during landings, takeoffs, and flight maneuvers. Yet during this testing, engineers working on the F-35 have found several key vulnerabilities. In 2010, an attachment joint between the vertical tail and the airframe on an Air Force F-35A failed and forced a redesign of the joint, which was later incorporated into the manufacturing process. While such early failures are expected and even planned for, 9 years on, serious deficiencies in the airframe continue to plague the aircraft. So far, the Marines' F-35B has been unable to complete the 3 lifetimes worth of testing, and no fix has been incorporated into the design. This means that when the F-35B goes into full-rate production later this year, the aircraft will only have a lifetime of 2,100 hours. The Marine Corps will have to start retiring the first of its F-35s in just 7 years, and may never receive an aircraft capable of carrying out an 8,000-hour service life. The Navy's F-35C managed to make it further along in testing, but tests were canceled halfway through the third lifetime iteration after damage to several structural components were discovered. The damage proved too costly to repair, and just like the F-35B, there are currently no plans to address the faults before the aircraft goes into full-rate production. At least the Navy's F-35s will last longer than the Marine Corps, but both versions of the aircraft will fall far short of the 8,000-hour service life requirement imposed by the Pentagon. The F-35's infamous Autonomic Logistics Information System, or ALIS, is also under intense scrutiny. Operated by Lockheed Martin, who boasted that the system would reduce operating costs and increase aircraft availability, this global network is supposed to integrate maintenance diagnostics and scheduling with supply chain management and combat mission planning and threat analysis. In plain speak, ALIS was meant to automate the F-35 supply chain by gathering data on what maintenance various planes needed, what missions they were slated for, and what threats they were expecting to fly against. This way, Lockheed Martin and other defense contractors could instantly and proactively respond to the maintenance need of the F-35, preparing and shipping parts and fixes as needed and taking a lot of the stress off the military. Yet the system has been plagued with false positive maintenance diagnoses, overworking aircraft maintainers with cumbersome data entry procedures, and slow uploads and downloads between the aircraft and ALIS. The system has so many flaws and failures that Lockheed Martin itself didn't use the system on their manufacturing floor until March 2018. Perhaps one of the most serious problems with the entire F-35 program is that there still exists no programming capacity to create the F-35's critical mission data loads. These are computer programs which include up-to-date information on enemy ground and air radar signals, missiles and jammers, and similar information for friendly units. Before flying each mission, an F-35 must be loaded with a mission data load that is specific to its current threat environment. And yet, the United States Reprogramming Laboratory at Florida's Eglin Air Force Base is not only well behind schedule creating these vital files, but lacks adequate equipment to test and optimize MDLs under conditions stressing enough to ensure adequate performance against current and future threats. Current F-35s are flying with old or incomplete information on enemy and friendly platforms, and this is a huge vulnerability for an aircraft whose advanced computers run powerful sensors and make use of the F-35's stealth features in order to keep a pilot safe. In order to ensure the onboard computers can keep an F-35 safe, its various sensors must be tested against accurate enemy radar signals, and yet current testing facilities are far inadequate for the task. While the US government has allocated funding for the acquiring of 8 high-fidelity signal emulator channels in each of its 2 test lines by the end of 2019, the F-35 program's own office states that it needs 16 to 20 such high-fidelity channels in each test line in order to adequately replicate near-peer threat signal environments for MDL testing. That means that the F-35s are currently and will continue to be deployed for years to come with inadequate testing of its various sensors against realistic threats. This could potentially place F-35 pilots in serious risk and jeopardize mission success. Touted as a computer that happens to fly, the F-35 has more brains than any other aircraft to date. Yet all those cyber brains are critically vulnerable to being hacked. Much the same way as any other computer system, a government accountability office released a report in 2018 showing that nearly every software-enabled weapon system tested between 2012 and 2017 could be hacked by an enemy, and often by simple means, such as looking up default passwords online for commercially available software. Some parts of the F-35 program use such commercially available software. ALIS, for instance, runs on Windows. Yet while cybersecurity testing has long been a part of the F-35 program and the testing office has kept any specific issues discovered secret, reports in 2018 showed that some of the vulnerabilities identified early on in testing still had not been fixed. Calls for more cyber testing of the aircraft and, more importantly, its supply chain have been made. Yet concerns over ALIS in particular are so significant that officials warned the US military should find a way to operate the F-35 entirely without it in case the network was compromised. While the F-35 has shown promising combat capabilities in flight exercises against 4th-generation aircraft from around the world, it's clear that the most ambitious aircraft ever created is also turning out to be one of the most difficult to actually field. While these are no indication of how the aircraft will perform in 10 years' time, the F-35 is en route to one of the most troubled rollouts in military history, and some have already called into question the continued superiority of the United States' air forces, not just in the near term, but in the long term as well. Only time will tell how the F-35 performs in future conflicts, but what is clear is that after billions invested, the Pentagon is committed to making the aircraft a success. Should the entire F-35 program be canceled? Why or why not? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, US F-35 versus Russian Su-35 fighter jet. Which would win? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.